Hey there, fellow gamers. Kevin J here, giving you some more Pokemon Platinum Versus. In the last episode, we got through Route 215 and 210, and it was a long route. Anyway, here we got to Veilstone. Also, check out Soul Primal side of the video, obviously. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah. Anyway, in this episode, we're here in Veilstone. We're going to look around. First off, this is a department store. I don't believe there's too much in it, but you know, I'm going to check their TM counter because I have a lot of money on me, so I'm going to go check to see if they have it. What do you say? Welcome to the Fabulous Veilstone Department Store. Somebody says what's on all the floors, right? Welcome, what do you need? Oh, well, you're selling potions, hyper potions, the regular stuff. I don't think there's anything in the basement, but we'll head to the basement first because I can. Whoa, what is this? Hello, I sell puffins! The ones I sell go for 6,400 each. I've never been here. Food and produce, trainer zone, battle collection, TM corners on the third floor, and rooftop plazas, so. Welcome to the basement, the food and produce section. We offer a fine, pleasing Pokemon food. We have planted berries on sale. Welcome, what do you need? I don't know, what do you sell? Oh, you sell berries. Okay. It's interesting, it's a grocery store. I didn't even know this was down here. I don't think it was in Pearl or Diamond. Diamond or whatever. We're gonna head up to the third floor just to check out the TM corner. Just to see what they have. Just for the sake of it. Because it'd be fun. I thought it'd be exciting. Anyway, one of these people... Yeah, see, you got, like, Solar Beam, Focus Blast. By the way, everyone in this game has Focus Blast. We're gonna grab... Let's grab a Blizzard. Because it never hurts to have an Ice move on hand. We're gonna grab a Focus Blast. Just so we have it. We're gonna grab a Hyper Beam, just so we have it. And grab a we'll grab one of everything. Except for Solar Beam, because we don't want Solar Beam. And there goes all my money. See if I have anything worth selling. Because I might have, like, a random nugget on me that I... Oh, we have Stardust here. Stardust sells for 1,000. We have a Big Pearl that sells... Yeah, we do have a nugget. 37... Yeah, 45, whatever. And there's a nugget. So there's all our money back. That works out. And I believe this person up here sells defensive TMs. Like... Natural Gift, False Swipe, which is always useful for catching Pokemon. Flash for Dark Caves. Let's buy two of those just so we have them. And I don't mind having Reflector Light Screen, so let's grab one of each of those as well. Mainly because when Lucina becomes an Espeon, those are not bad to have on Espeon. We'll grab a Protect, because Protect is useful. And you know what, we'll grab a False Swipe, just because False Swipe is obviously useful against... Again, when trying to catch Pokemon. False Swipe will never kill a Pokemon, faint a Pokemon. It'll always leave them with at least 1 HP. So, it's quite useful. Anyway, back down here on the first floor. Hello? The department store knows how to ensure customer satisfaction. They really look after you once you become a regular customer. Well, that actually has nothing to do with the game, so... Whatever. We're back here in Veilstone. We're back outside in Veilstone. There's a lot of things to do around here. I believe in here... There are Pokemon who desire to see them. Pokemon will appear in many different guises. Myths say that Mount Corn imparted Sinnoh into halves. Shellos makes the Smith real. Because Shellos has two different versions depending on where you're looking in the water. Anyway, what do you say? You're a trainer, aren't you? You see, there's this Pokemon I'd like someone to go after. It's called Pokemon. I found it near Team Galactic's building. I'm no trainer. Can you take it off? Oh, sweet. I'll take it. So we get a Porygon. That's nice. I'm not going to use it. I might have used it, but I'm not going to. I know I said the same thing about Eevee, I wasn't going to use it, but I'm actually not using this Porygon, or at least I don't plan on using this Porygon. I already have a normal type on me right now. Nothing's wrong with Porygon, especially when it becomes Porygon Z, or Z for me, in my case, because I'm Canadian. But I'm not going to use Porygon just because it is a glass cannon, and a normal type glass cannon isn't great. Mainly because it doesn't get stabbed from a lot of things. It doesn't get a lot, so... Porygon, there we go. Boo! Boo, 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 boo. Anyway, so we're back in Veilstone. And one more thing we're going to check before we take on the gym. Oh, right, there's a gym here. We're going to check out this. This is the Game Corner. Welcome to Veilstone Game Corner. Do you want some coins for slots? Oh, I'm sorry, you don't have a coin case to hold. Where do you get the coin case? I think the young man next door had one. Okay, then we'll head next door and get one. The music in there is really cool. So we're going to run over to the guy next door. This is where you cash in your tokens, by the way. They have prizes I really want, but coins I have none. I woke up and realized my potential. So what potential was woken in me? It's my hidden power, you ask. Beyond hidden power, I'll tell you what type of Pokemon. That guy just teaches you, just tells you what type of hidden power your Pokemon uses. Do you know where one might find a coin case? I heard that there's one clown giving him away. Okay, so there's a clown giving him away. Next door, the only other next door place in this place would be here. Oh, thank you, Q-Ball. It's this guy. You there, watch this coin. Spin, spin, spin. Now which hand is the coin in? Left. Bravo, the winner is you. For our winner, I have a coin case. Yay! We got a coin case. There we go. That holds on to all our coins. We're just going to want that to play at the game corner, which I'm going to do real quick just to show you how it works. Because the game corner in this game is actually the only time the game corner was ever cool, in my opinion. We're just going to do 50 coins. We only need 50 in reality. I don't know why I like the music here. Anyway. So let's run over to one of these machines. We'll try this one. I don't remember how to do this now. X is to insert coins. X. And you do Y, B, A. Didn't get anything. Y, B, A. We didn't get anything. B, A, Y. Nothing. Oh, see, as you can see at the bottom screen, there's a Pokeball shifting around there. We got a replay there, which is good, but that Pokeball went away, so that's not good. It was a great ball. Be-doo. Be-doo, be-doo, be-doo.
Like my other one's something. Oh, come on. Oh, come on, I gotta win one of these. I want a single spin. Okay, there's another great ball down there. Got another replay, so that's gonna make the ball go away. Oh, come on. Ah. I got a replay every time the ball's there. There's an ultra ball down there now. We got Pikachu there, that's 10. Another great ball. Get a replay every single time that ball's down here. Yeah, I'm leaving this one. This machine's not good for me. Try this one. Nope, not starting out very good. It's a premier ball down there. And then do anything. Another premier ball. Get the replay, nothing happens.
And there we go. That is my last spin. Oh, we got the moonstone. And it makes a Ditto Clefairy appear. There's a Clefairy on the bottom screen, as you can see. So now what we need to do is we need to go until we can at least get a lucky 7, which might not come. We get a replay, which helps. Another replay. Oh, I almost got Galactic. Galactic's actually worth the same amount as Plasma. I'm gonna get the Moonstone. That's gonna keep us going. And we got the replay there. We're gonna get nothing on that one. Nothing on that one. Oh, come on. The Clefairy's right there. I got a replay. Ah. Nothing on that one. Galactic. Moonstone. Nope, nothing. 7? Nope, no 7. And it. Oh, we got Pikachu there, so we're gonna keep going. Oh, jeez. Oh, Galactic! Oh. We got a Galactic 7. We got a 7. Oh. Galactic 7. Galactic! Galactic! Yay! We got a Galactic. That gives us 100, and we got bonus 15. Now, as you can see, as we spin here, Clefairy in the bottom is actually going to be telling us which order to go in. Every time we get a replay, we get 15 tokens. You have to do it fast, and you have to keep up. You have to keep up with Clefairy. And I believe the faster you do it, the better chances you have. We're just going to keep going.
We're going to keep going. This is actually the best way to get tokens. We've now already exceeded the 50 we started with. We're just going to keep going. And because of the way this works, this is actually, the first time I've actually maxed out my coin case. I actually maxed out at 50,000.
And Pikachu's come out and they talk to her, and then that's round two, so we're gonna keep going. Basically, we have to keep. We have to keep. sleep. We have to keep this Clefairy around for as long as we can. Even though this is actually a Ditto Clefairy, not even a real Clefairy. So I've gotten real Clefairies. You can even get a shiny Clefairy down there. I believe when the red's up there, you're supposed to get it wrong. I'm not totally sure. I've heard that. Maybe I'm wrong on that. Maybe you guys can inform me a little bit more. I remember I looked it up a long time ago. Oh, then it goes back in anyway. Well, we got 406 tokens off that, so. Just so you guys understand what it's like. That's how the game corner works. And, oh, also, this is Looker. Ah, it is you, yes. Examine, if you will, the real, the Team Galactic logo. It is here. Further investigation is needed, and I am just the man to do it. Also, where the masses gather, so too does information. Ah, my streak is broken. Anyway, so that's the game corner. I've just spent a whole bunch of time showing it off. So now what we're going to do is we're going to take on the gym. At least we're going to get in there. And I'm going to show you guys around, and maybe we'll get close to taking on the... Oh, hello, Don.
Kevin J., are you going to take the gym challenge? Gee, you keep getting tougher and tougher, don't you? Me? Well, I went shopping at the department store and... I mean, well, of course, I've been working on my Pokedex, but...
Whoa.
My ring is the rolling sea. The towering waves have shaped me. Crash, crash, crash awake. Crash, crash, crash awake. I'm the tidal wave of power to wash you away. Put on the fire, crash awake. Run away from electricity. Crash awake. Aha, the ring is my sea. Hello, dude and young lady. You're challenging the gym leader, are you? Let me tell you now, she's young, but she's a born genius. I tried training her, and I was stunned by how tough she was. Whoops, I better tell you who I am. I'm the triple threat gym leader in Pokemon Wrestling and Song. I'm Crasher Wake of Pastoria Gym. We'll meet again. Okay. Okay. Oh yeah, brother.
So, Kevin J., good luck with the gym challenge. Bye. Goodbye, Don. Whatever. Here we go.
Just gonna show you around the gym here. Boo boo da da. Hey there, how's it going, champ to be? The gym leader is the user of the fighting type Pokemon. She'd be a terror against normal type Pokemon, but, and it's a big but, just between you and me, Maylene, the gym leader, said flying and psychic type Pokemon could be real trouble for her. If you want to battle her, smack the punching bags along the wall, along the rail, and you hit those bags hard. Anyway, so we're gonna have to switch Lucina out, because Lucina is not gonna be able to do it, so we're gonna put Sheffy out in front. Anyway. I was always really confused by how this gym worked, but basically, you bump into them by walking into them, and they knock out those. Like, it's a little confusing, personally. Like, I don't even totally get it. But then, like, you can walk over here, and you can push this one all the way up, and that's just where it goes. Like, that's it. Can you bump it again? And you bump it again, and now we can sneak through here. But now we have to fight that guy. So that knocks out those. Can I run around that way or no? I don't think I can go under that. Oh yeah, I can. So now I've snuck my way around here. See, that's gonna knock those out. I'm gonna have to hit it again. So it knocks those out. And we have to find our way over to the other side now. The confusing thing is, like, you have to fight a whole bunch of trainers here. Or, like, I'm not sure if I have to fight all of them or not. Well, I think I have to fight you at least. Well, now you've cut off my path. Me.
My karate quads. Hiya!
Whatever. Honestly, I think the puzzle in here was different in Generation 4 because I never remembered it being this hard until I played through Platinum recently. Anyway, opens up with a crow gunk. I open up with my Sheffy. It's not as cute as. But anyway, we're just gonna spark it. And it's gonna do a lot of damage. So we're just gonna spark it. Kablammo! Might have Limber so it won't get paralyzed. Paralyzed, you know what I mean. Swagger is not a good thing to be using, ever. Because it raises my attack, and I get that it's accurate, and it confuses me, but if I hit, you gave me +2 attack. It's very risky, so there you go. Yeah, that's a +2 attack right there. It's a +2 spark. Get stabbed. 2-stage attack? Jeez, it's strong. Anyway. And we're level 27. Bonnet is level there. It's Machoke. For Machoke, I'ma use Bonnet. just because I feel like Bonnet can go in there and kick some tail. Anyway. So I'm just gonna use Flame Wheel on it. Flame Wheel's decently strong. Kablammo! Fire goes everywhere. You have been out. I was hoping to do a lot more. That Karate Chop hurts. That hurts a little bit. Come on, Flame Wheel! Take that! And one more Flame Wheel should finish it off. Goes for the Foresight. I can't even imagine a Machoke holding a magnifying glass. I don't know why he would. But anyway, Flame Wheel. And there goes my... Oh, I got a critical hit too, so that's going to take a Machoke. And that's almost enough for level 29 on Bonnet. I'm going to probably switch the XP share over to Sheffy soon. Anyway, I'm trying to remember where to go. This is what I always hated about this gym, is you get confused, and you're not sure where to go and where to look and things, and... I'm sure I can avoid this guy, though. There we go. We avoided him, which is good. Now we gotta figure out what to do from here. I think I can knock that over. I didn't do anything. I think maybe I needed to push it this way. And then push it up, maybe? Let me think. Let's find out. Honestly, this gym is confusing. I never liked the puzzle in here. That's gonna swing all the way over there. Hit this, and that's gonna knock out those. And now we have control of this one, which is gonna go up. And it goes all the way up to there. I gotta hit that last one. I gotta sneak by you to do it, though. Oh, jeez, that was close. Okay. I figured it out, because then you hit this one, this crashes into that one, and then you hit this one, crashes into that one, and once there was, if you remember, there was tires right here. You knock out those tires, you've knocked out all the tires, you bump this over, takes that out, and now you have to run around the long way, because, yeah. But here we are, it's Maylene. What do these signs say? Treasure. Treasure every encounter, for it is unique. One day at a time. A good deed for every day. Whatever. I don't know why I went to my bag there. Let me just check to make sure my Pokemon are all decently good. Bonnet's taking some damage. So we're going to give you a potion just to top you off there. Two health off isn't too bad. Okay, you ready, Maylene? Are you ready? Are you ready to get your butt whooped? Bring it.
Hello, I'm pleased to meet you. I'm Maylene, and I'm the gym leader. Don't really know what it means to be strong or how I got to be the gym leader, but I will do the best as I can as the gym leader. I take battling very seriously. Whenever you're ready.
Bring it on, Maylene. You're gonna kick me in the face and that screen. Here she is now. Up, giant. I don't know. I think Maylene's cool. Anyway, opens up in the Metatite. I'm going to open up with Sheffy. We're not too underleveled in this, but needless to say, this fight is going to be difficult. It's actually quite a difficult fight for us. I'm going to spark it. My spark does a decent amount of damage. Of course you know Fake Out. Of course you know everything you need to know to win, don't you? Don't you? Anyway, I'm just going to spark it and do whatever I can. Spark it! And it does half your health, but then this drink... They all know Drain Punch, and it's such a pain in the butt, because it does a lot of damage, and you get, it seems like, 1-to-1 of the health back, so... Like, I do a lot of damage. Well, I got the crit there, so that worked out for us. Okay, so I guess that works out. Bonnet gets some experience. Gonna throw out her Lucario. Lucario is her best Pokemon at level 32, so it's not impossible to do. It's not an impossible fight. All I can do here is just Flame Wheel and hopefully get the burn. But it just spams Drain Punch. And there's nothing we can do about it. It's just gonna spam Drain Punch. And it does so much damage. I just have to hope I get a burn here. It's the only chance I have is to hopefully get a burn. I do so much damage, too. I do so much damage, but it does not matter. That is the stupid thing about this. The only way I'm ever going to take out this Lucario is if I can hit it with a couple of flame wheels. And Sheffy comes out, that's going to lower your attack. That's why I'm doing this. I don't care if Sheffy gets defeated off this. Goes for Bone Rush. That was well played, I guess. How'd you know I was going to switch out to my electric type that already had low health? But now your attack's lowered. I switch out to Lucina. I know, Lucina, you're going to get defeated. But I'm going to have to spike you up in levels anyway. So we're just going to have to use a Moo Moo Milk on Bonnet. Those Moo Moo Milks are paying off pretty well. Anyway, goes for the Force Palm. That's easily going to take out Lucina. I am sorry, Lucina, but I had to do it. I had to. Even though you may have been defeated, but you did good. You did good. Out comes Bonnet again. Probably is going to go for another Drain Punch. Yeah, so it's going to get a lot of its health back off this. But it doesn't defeat me. Also, your attack's been lowered again. So it doesn't even two-shot me anymore. So I should defeat it now with this Flame Wheel and one more attack. Even if he gets the Drain Punch. Ooh, that's probably going to be an item. Oh, it doesn't use the item. Goes for another Drain Punch. But I should win this turn unless this is a crit. And it wasn't. Didn't get much of its health back. Flame Wheel, you're done. Get out of here. There goes Lucario. Now Lucario's out. Now keep in mind, we do still have my Empa still in the wings. So, last Pokemon's going to be a Machoke. I'm just going to let Bonnet go until it's defeated, mainly because I'm not sure what this Machoke can do. I might even be faster than it, and I am, so I get the free attack off with this Flame Wheel. Works out pretty well in our favor. Does a lot of damage. Doesn't do a lot, but does a good amount of damage. Now Rock Tomb's going to hurt, and there goes Bonnet. But we got some damage out, so now it's all up to Empa, who's the exact same level, to do his best to defeat this. So let's see how much damage a Peck will do. That strength is gonna hurt a little bit because it's a decently strong move, but this Peck does not that much. So we're gonna have to use Bubble Beam. Keep in mind, Peck doesn't get stab, and it is physical, which Empa doesn't have the highest physical stats. But this Bubble Beam is going to do a fair bit. And see what happens. Is it enough? Ooh, it is! There goes Machoke. We didn't have to use all that many items in reality. We used one Moo Moo Milk on Bonnet, and we sacrificed Lucina on Sheffy. But we did it. I shall admit defeat. We get 7,680 Pokédollars. Okay, you win. That was a tough loss. I learned a lot from it. Please accept this Gin Badge. We got the Cobble Badge from Maylene. I should explain about that official Pokemon League Gym Badge. With it, you can use the hidden move Fly outside of battle. Oh, and since you now have 4 Gym Badges, Pokemon obtained in trades will obey you up to level 50. Oh, and please take this as well. We get TM60. This is Drain Punch. So we do get the Drain Punch that she was using on us. I'm not sure who the heck's going to use it on our team. But, you know, like, whatever. Anyway, we're going to bump this out of the way. Whoa. There goes that. And we're just going to run over here, run through here, and we are back out. We oddly did it. Anyway, so Dawn's here waiting for us, and she's like,
"Hi, Kevin J, please can you help me? Some Galactic Goons took my Pokedex away from me.
I need your help to get it back. I'll be waiting in front of the warehouses. Please come."
Okay. Well, I think we've had our fun here today. So, next time on Pokemon Platinum Versus, we're going to be seeing what was going on in the land of Dawn and Team Galactic and whatever they're doing and stuff, but we have gotten the Cobble Badge. So anyway, I'll talk to you guys all next time. Thanks for watching.